Today I'm going to be improving the thermal efficiency of my loft hatch. This is an old loft hatch. It was built, well, it was installed when the house was built circa 1997. And what I've done so far with it is I've put decorator's cork all the way around the edges and inside I've placed some draft excluder. It does have a problem still. There are three points of contact with it. One's the hatch and the other two points are the hinges. So as we put this loft hatch up, it's got a tendency to sag. I've looked at this on my thermal camera and we've got a few dark spots in this area all around, so that's where it's leaking. Probably because there's only one point of contact there with a catch. And it also sags slightly here. There's evidence of air leakage and dust staining on the draft excluder I put. So I've came up with a solution and hopefully it will work. What I've done is I've cut a piece of wood to cover the loft hatch. You can see here, that's my previous efforts. There's dust staining there. So air's been leaking through there and out into the void. You can get a suction effect with a loft, a bit like a chimney, because the eaves are ventilated. So what I plan to do is put some sealant in there, draft excluder. And I've got a neat little idea, because this piece of wood is chipboard, it's all I had without buying any wood, but it's got quite a good bit of weight to it. It's quite a solid piece, it's quite a densely constructed chipboard. So I've got a neat little idea to apply some tension to pull this down to ensure a perfectly airtight seal, all being well. Well, I've made a couple of handles just to ease positioning in the loft. I'll just finish screwing them down. Problem is, you're up on ladders, can be tricky. Give that a test fit. Good news, I've now got sufficient clearance to allow this bit here, which stands proud, it does actually shut, so that's excellent. Okay, next stage is a good clean. I've got a bit of washing up liquid on a cloth. I'm going to give everything a good clean. The plan is to put some draft excluder on this. I want to give it the best possible chance of sticking. This edge here will have the draft excluder built up in layers. You can see I've already sealed down that with some decorator's cork. So every edge which it's touching will become sealed. Okay, I've built up some layers of draft excluder here. There's four layers there. I've put a bit of silicone behind it just to secure it in place. The theory being that it's going to be compressed. I've also put some in the corners just to try and eradicate any weak points. And we've got that done all the way around. So, I'll have a test fit and see. So this is our test fit, and you may not be able to see it on camera, but I can see a bit of daylight through there. It's not perfectly sitting true. Apologies for the darkness of this, but I was trying to demonstrate something, but it's going to require some pressure to pull it down to achieve a perfectly good seal.
One thing I do have in my arsenal is some old radiator brackets. I replaced a radiator a couple of weeks ago, and these are now surplus to requirement, so I'm going to do a bit of adaptation work with a view to repurposing them for the task. Okay, I've smoothed around the edges there, just in case. They're quite jagged. I just took a hand file to them and smoothed them around. Bit more work on that. All sorted. Okay, I've got my brackets here and I've just gave them a light dusting with some spray paint just to improve the edges which I've worked on. And I think the next step is to go back to the loft and work on the insulation. Real view, we're now in the loft, and as you can see, I've been working on my loft and we've managed to achieve 1 foot thickness of insulation, 300 mil in the region of that, and I've got a roll left over, so my plan is to cover the loft hatch in this, and I'm going to slightly oversize it. I've left a bit of a gap there just so it laps rather than butts. The idea being, the view in the loft hatch area, I want to insulate it to the same standard as the rest of the loft, ideally, or as close as I can possibly achieve. Well, I've cut two pieces off. That's the first piece, that's the second. These are going above the loft hatch. And I've got a curved needle and a bit of thread. I'm going to start sewing them together. You can only do this if your insulation is of the correct type. I've got what's called itch-free loft insulation, which is really good. It's lovely to the touch. It's just nylon. So I'll finish this off. But I have got my loft hatch insulation to the same height as the insulation which is in my loft, so hopefully there's just one more job to do now, and that's to peel it back and glue it to the board. I've got some sealant adhesive. I could easily use spray adhesive, but I've already got this, so I'm going to be using this, and I'm just going to put some on. I'm gonna give it a good press on. I just got to flip it and do the other side first. We've got our bracket here, which I've fixed just below the sealant and draft excluder. Then we have the other bracket here, that's affixed again just below the draft excluder. We have our hatch there, which has been gluing for a couple of hours now, so it should be good to go. So I'll have a go at reassembling this. Next step is to mark and put some pilot holes in there, taking care not to work too close to the edge of the wood. You want to be pretty much in a straight line. You can see I've got a screw in there, which is really good.
screw in there. We've got four screws in now, so I can tighten them up a little and really lock this loft hatch down, making it airtight, which is really good for thermal efficiency. Do bear in mind that many loft hatches are different. I've done what I think were required for my loft hatch type to improve it. You know, the recipe for your loft hatch could be totally different due to its different construction. But best of luck if you're attempting such a project. I do have a question for you. And the question is, if you were to do your loft hatch, how would you do it differently? In my case, if I hadn't already bought the insulation, I would have got some board insulation and put that over the top of it. But since I had it, I used it. Well, thanks very much for watching. Please like and subscribe for more videos.